10 things to master in GA4 before you can call yourself a true expert of the tool. Let's go. Number one, measurement. How does data from your website or mobile app get into Google Analytics 4? Yes, through measurement. You installed a tracking code and your data is flowing in the tool, but not so fast. There is an opportunity to use tools like Google Tag Manager to send special kinds of data into GA4 and manipulate it to suit your needs. That's the basis of real customization, getting data that is relevant to your organization. So I encourage you to master the measurement part of Google Analytics 4 so you send the right data into your tool so you can use it later on. Now, something that was newly introduced in GA4 is the ability to track app plus web alongside in one interface, which can be super powerful. But with this comes great responsibility because it's more important than ever to map out your tracking beforehand so you actually get usable data in your reports later on. Number two, the new data model and custom metrics and dimensions. Yes, I know we start out slow, but the data model is really the fundamental thing to understand in GA4 on your road to becoming an expert in the tool. Understanding the idea that everything resolves around an event will allow you to really customize your installation for your clients needs. And only the ones that can customize the tool to the business model can call really themselves an expert. The ultimate way to customize your GA4 installation is to track custom data points. With custom metrics and dimensions, you are able to do so. In GA4, we have now 50 available for the metrics and dimensions, depending on what scope they are. But this really gives us a new level and room to customize our implementation. You need to understand how you can utilize dimensions and metrics correctly in order to make your GA4 data better. But be careful with custom data in GA4. You might want to use certain names, certain conventions that are already out there on how to send data into the system so Google Analytics can actually interpret them. It's not as easy, but read up on custom dimensions and metrics and understand the data model in there. Number three are then simply the events and conversions itself. Now, events are the basic building block of Google Analytics 4's data. And understanding the four different types of events that can be received by GA4 and how they are interpreted is vital for your reporting needs later on. Connected to that, you shouldn't skip on a solid foundation of naming your events correctly and choosing the right events, the right parameters, so you can make sure your data is later on usable in your reports. All this can make or break your data points later on. Now, once the data is in the system, you should set up conversions. The new flow of marking a conversion inside of Google Analytics 4 is really easy to understand, but sometimes people miss certain parts because they need to dissect certain events and make sure that only certain parts of the event are actually counted towards the conversion goals. So make sure you understand this as well. And then number four are enhanced measurement events. One of the surprising additions to GA4 has been enhanced measurements, or so-called GA4 auto tracking functionality. Installing scroll, form, or error link tracking is taken care of by the tool by default. Now, that's great news for everyone who doesn't want to spend their time customizing their installation, just is okay with the normal data that flows into the account. But anybody who wants to turn pro, you need to know how these events are actually tracked and understand when these enhanced measurement forms actually fall flat and what problems they might bring into your account if the data doesn't show as expected. As I always say, not all tracking is measuring equally, and this functionality can oftentimes break. And on the other hand, it's well worth it to know how to set up these enhanced measurement events by yourself manually in Google Tag Manager in order for your tracking to be rock solid and you actually being able to understand it and debug it later on. Number five, the interface and explorations. Now, finding the right data in GA4 once you have it in the system might not be all too hard for you right now, but you can really put your GA4 skills to the max by using all the different features to wrangle your data around, build custom reports, and make sure that you get to the insights that you're looking for. Now, from filters, comparisons, adding custom reports into the library, there's a lot that you can get efficient with in GA4 reporting section. And then there's a whole different reporting module with explorations. Now, I haven't been able to figure out half of the things that you can do there, and I always find new functionality when I play around with it. But yeah, you need to know your data really well in order to put it together from scratch inside of the exploration section. Then can be really, really powerful, the different visualization forms, the funnel building, and being able to really build the report that you are envisioning. So it's definitely something you can spend hours with before calling yourself a master. Number 6, reporting identity and Google Signals. Now, how does GA4 identify a user? The answer in the past would have been mainly cookies, but with the growing privacy restrictions, it's not always possible to use them. That's why GA4 introduced some new methods to help us fill the gaps in our data. You can combine data from cookies with your Google Signals, with device ID, and even the model data from Google Analytics 4. And this all can be controlled in the admin section of GA4. Now, knowing about these different ID methods is vital for understanding your data later on in your reporting and how it can affect your reporting. Now, for instance, Google Signals can be a mess with the data that it applies to it and then the thresholding that might occur as well. But unfortunately, it's necessary to install Google Signals in order to use Google Ads effectively with the GA4 reporting capabilities. Now, question is, are you willing to make that trade-off? Do you understand actually that trade-off? So knowing about these different reporting identities, how to implement them, how to use them effectively, and how they impact your data is vital for understanding GA4. Number 7, attribution and modeling. Now, who gets credit for a particular conversion? That's what attribution is all about. And GA4 offers automatic attribution with a preferred model, but that doesn't make things easier. For instance, not every report is using the same attribution model, and you need to get used to the quirks and the different attributions that are out there. Added on top on that is a different understanding in GA4 about sessions, which you also should really learn about and how that impacts your attribution. And by the way, Charles Farina has a great blog post on this, on all the quirks and how you cannot trust attribution quite just yet in GA4. Hopefully Google fixes that. Another complication is the new modeling features that are going on in the background. So if you use consent mode in combination with GA4, Google might model your data, which means it will fill the gaps automatically based on the data that you already sent into the system and based on their machine learning algorithms. This is a really cool feature because you might be missing data based on the privacy features that you have installed on your website or tracking prevention that might be going on. At the same time, it's a little bit black box. So really it's trial and error to find out what data is modeled, what not, and how does it really impact your data overall. So keep an eye out for modeling going on in your account. Number 8 is then BigQuery and Looker Studio integrations. Now, thank God GA4 doesn't pretend to do everything in the analytics world. Reporting and dashboarding, for instance, is not particularly good in GA4, but Google offers a free connection to Looker Studio, which lets you pull in data from GA4 and then create your reports, your dashboards on the fly in this cool interface. And obviously, this is really cool when you need to present data or show it to a client. And the best thing about this is that you won't ever need them to log into GA4 because you can share the report out to them without them having access to the data source itself. Now, if you want to take this a step further, and this is what the professionals really do, is use the BigQuery connector. Because Google Analytics 4 gave us the ability to connect directly to the warehousing solution of Google, which is BigQuery. That way we can get all our raw data out of the system and use it however we want. That means you can do analysis on your data with the attribution model that you want, for example. You can combine your data with your CRM data, for example, or export it out to some other tool that does a better job of analyzing that data than GA4 itself does. Now, for BigQuery, you need to have a little bit of learning in SQL in order to get things working and output the data that you want. We have a tutorial right over here what BigQuery is all about. But suffice to say, Looker Studio and BigQuery are definitely something you should be looking into if you haven't yet. Number 9, the audience builder and segmentation. Analysis in GA4 is all about filtering down on your data and getting to that insight. And the most powerful way of filtering your data set is through segments and the audience builder. The new possibilities of the audience builder let you dig into data like never before because you have the ability to use things like sequences and implement time on this one as well. But you really need to have a good understanding of that data itself and how it's put together. A fundamental piece to understand here is what scope is all about, and it's basically which parts of your data a dimension is assigned to. And it's really crucial to understand that part so you'll be able to use your segments effectively, put the data together. Otherwise, you might get garbage out when you're building your report. On top of that, the audience builder has the cool new feature of the audience triggers, which basically build you membership groups that you can assign your users to and actually also deploy an event, which you can then turn into a conversion, which makes it a really cool feature. At the same time, makes it a bit harder to debug later on to know where events are actually coming from. So the audience builder is definitely a standout feature in GA4, but it takes a lot of practice to really master it. And then finally, number 10, the measurement protocol and APIs. The tracking code is not the only way to send data into GA4. You can also use the measurement protocol, which is GA4's own API, so to say. With this endpoint, you can connect GA4 really to anything from Shopify backend to your point of sale system, to your Stripe and so on, really any software that can connect to an API. This is very powerful. You probably would use it together with your developer in order to make that connection work. And there is a learning curve involved because you need to get the request right in order to show the data correctly in the system itself later on. But the ability to get away from just the tracking code is a really, really cool feature inside GA4, and they made it even better with this version. All right, before you go, there is one bonus that I need to mention, and this is the 11th thing that you kind of need to master, which are the quirks and the shortcomings of GA4. Yes, I need to make this last point. GA4 isn't perfect. The biggest challenge over the past few months is dealing with the shortcomings, which might or might not be fixed soon. That's always the question in GA4. It can be really frustrating working with the tool and finding inconsistencies, and then the data is going away or the data changes later on, and then you realize that certain things are not behaving as they should. Now, if you're already on your way mastering this tool, then you will need to learn to live with these uncertainties. And that's kind of the thing that I don't want to say, but at the same time, it is the truth. Maybe we should all embrace just the quirks of this tool right now. There are many resources which you can choose in order to stay up to date, to know what other workarounds do other people come out with, to know if this data is actually right or wrong, and if this is something that you did wrong in your implementation, or if it's a shortcoming of the website. That obviously takes a lot of time, takes a lot of digging into the forums, knowing and reading up on newest developments in the industry. And there are many different resources out there. I hope we are one of these resources for you in the future. And if you want to dive deeper into GA4, we have tons of tutorials. Click right over here.